Hi, it's Bob Kraft of TennisMinistry.org, and right now they're getting ready to play the Wimbledon Championships. It's about 8 a.m. in the morning in London. The players are up, they're excited, they probably have had their breakfast or they're having their breakfast right at this moment. Now in Hong Kong, where I'm based, it's about 2 p.m. And I'm actually recording this from my new home office center, which is in my background, which is in my home, and I'm very thankful for that. So I get to do the outreach from a different location. It may interest you to know that we still have 300 or so pro players in my Facebook contacts. I have probably hundreds more that are on the email list that I built up over a 10-year period of reaching the players. I have 38,000 in our entire worldwide database, which would include fans, coaches, and press people, many, many kinds of different people through the emails. And the website has had 34,000 people who've come to the website in the last 3 years. So the ministry is still ongoing, and even though I'm not there. What I wanted to share with you a little bit today is about if you were planning on taking a trip to the All England Championships. Many of you have already done so, and some of you probably many more have not gone to the championships, but you want to go. So I want to just share with you my own experiences, and maybe that will help you and give you some ideas, and also encourage you to pray for the people and maybe even develop an outreach to the All England Club Championships, or better known as Wimbledon. When you get off at, when you land at Heathrow or one of the nearby airports in London, a few years I had people pick me up who were affiliated with the churches, because I always work with churches, but there were other times that I actually had to take the tube from the airport to the championships, to Wimbledon Center, and it took about an hour and a half maybe to get there. The first time was a little bit complicated, but not so difficult that you can't figure it out, and people are very friendly, and it's not that expensive. It's probably $35 or $40 to take the go from the airport to the Wimbledon Center. Now, the main difficulty with going to the championships is finding a place to stay. Again, I always stayed with people who were affiliated with the churches, because I have good relationships with a number of churches there. But on the other hand, you know, there aren't really hotels or hostels near the Wimbledon village itself. You can find them, but they're very hard to find, and they're very expensive, $200, $300, $400 a night, out of the budget of most people. So another idea is to stay in one of the hotels such as Formula One, a chain of low-cost hotels located in Europe, or Accor, A-C-C-O-R, hotels. They tend to run $30, $40, or $50 U.S. dollars a night. And now they may not be nearby to the Wimbledon Center itself, but you know, you can take a tube there. It would take no more than an hour. And once you arrive, Wimbledon Village is up on the hill, and Wimbledon Center is the commercial area of Wimbledon. So you have shopping malls, you have grocery stores, you can stack up with food that you're going to eat down there, normal sandwiches and so forth. And then they also have fast food places, and the restaurants are more moderately priced. Now when you walk up the hill to Wimbledon Village, which is about a 10-minute walk, their restaurants are very expensive, so you need a budget to do that. And they do have one kind of a fast food outlet for, it's called Tesco Express, where they sell sandwiches and food. It's not like a McDonald's at all. There's nothing like that in Wimbledon Village, but you can actually buy something and take it away. That's convenient too, and it's affordable. The restaurants in the Wimbledon Village tend to be very expensive, but I would just like to share with you that that's a great place to go, because if you just sit there along the sidewalk in a restaurant, have a cup of coffee, or you go to the Starbucks, which is, they have outdoor tables, probably 100% chance you're going to see well-known players walk by, because they tend to walk up and down the streets, go to the restaurants, have a cup of coffee. It's a very relaxed and informal atmosphere. And actually, I had one year where I did outreach where I just sat in the Starbucks. I was totally exhausted, and having done ministry 7 weeks before in different tournaments, And I just sat in Starbucks and said, Lord, send me people. And he did. And that, because the players knew me, that helped a lot. I was able to communicate with them, pray with them, and give them material. But having said that, it's not impossible to see people like Maria Sharapova or Andy Roddick or Venus or Serena Williams sitting in table restaurants or sitting there on the outdoor cafes. And it's a really relaxed, the weather is almost always good. Of course, it's known for having a lot of rain in England, but it rains infrequently, you could say. And when it does rain, it rains hard. So, you know, you can sit there and enjoy the atmosphere. Now, going to the tournament is about another 10-minute walk, and you pass these big, beautiful homes with rose bushes and rose gardens and expensive cars. And what I'll share with you there is, in my feeling, is that that particular area of London is materialistic, very materialistic. There are a lot of churches on every corner. Don't get me wrong. There you can find churches. But for sure, the people who live there are wrapped up in materialism. And we just need to pray for them that they can have a heart to give and to live within modest means so that they can give more to help proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because not only can you reach people, but you also have to be reached yourself with the truth of the message of Christ. Live within your means. And then, you know, getting tickets to the All England Club Championships, there are ways to get them through the internet, but also they have a ticket booth there. And I'm not really sure how that all works. I think you have to wait in a queue, and there are a certain number of tickets per day you can purchase. Very affordable. And then once they run out of tickets, they don't allow people to get back in the grounds. I was always fortunate because I never had to buy a ticket. I always had a credential. I had players inviting me or whoever, and I was able to get in the tournament without that. But I understand that there are many people who want to go and enjoy that atmosphere. I would strongly encourage it. It's a lovely place. But also, go there and be with open, if you're a Christian, be there open and have an understanding of what's behind all that you see and all that you experience it. While yes, you'll be walking by fabulous homes, you'll be walking by people who have a lot of money, pray for them. Pray that God will release their funds to be used for the purposes of sharing the gospel. You'll see players, pray for the players. Pray for the administrators of the All England Club Championships that they can have more of a desire to keep their traditions alive, which are really based in the Christian scriptures, because the Wimbledon had a number of winners in the early 1800s, 1880, that were pastors, and they were people who worked in the church. And they also, that's not an accident that on Sunday they don't play matches. They don't start the tournament on Sunday. Most tournaments do, and they start on Monday. And that's very much the players appreciated. I appreciated it. It gave us a breath of fresh air, and players were able to go to church, some of them. And then there were also, the middle Sunday, they don't play matches for the same reasons, unless it's an absolutely urgent situation where, for example, they've had a whole week of rain and they need to catch up the schedule. But that's only happened, I believe, once or twice in the history of the championships. And then the finals are played on Sunday, and that allows the players to get to the next tournament, which starts on Monday usually, or Tuesday. So, you know, I do appreciate that the All England Club Championship Committee has kept their traditions, and they're under a lot of pressure to start on Sunday, I'm sure, because of the income potential that could generate from having television viewership on Sunday. They can sell rights to television on Sunday, which is when most expensive time for ads, and we just need to keep praying for them. So thanks a lot. If you're there, enjoy the matches, pray for the people. If you're not there, continue to pray for them and pray for me, because there's a lot happening from my end too. Even though I'm not there, I'm still doing a lot of ministry work around the world to tennis players and to the players themselves. Thanks.